Friends and fellow conservatives, it is a pleasure to be here today to address you as part of my campaign in the New Hampshire primaries. As many of you know who've seen my face on billboards all over your fair state, my name is Tom Wilson, and I am an advocate of clean rock and roll. So for that reason, today on the Music Factory, I'm not bringing you that slimy, stinking, messed up stuff that so many of my opponents have tried to foist off on your ears. We're playing good, clean music. And I know that I do not have the dulcet, pleasing tones of those lady disc jockeys. But who wants a dirty young woman when you can get a clean old man? So here we are with our guest today, Bobby Callender.
I'll vote for that.
So will Eleanor Rigby.
Yes.
Destroys everything they hold dear, family, home, and their men, fathers, husbands, lovers. Terra is home for Scarlett O'Hara and the heart of the Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer film classic, Gone with the Wind. The original soundtrack album of Gone with the Wind captures Terra and Scarlett. Never available before, now exclusively on MGM Records.
Yo, Pat Williams, produced by Pete Spargo, and I understand that record is breaking loose out on the West Coast. Eleanor Rigby was the track, and I think that was written by some fellows over in London. I don't know the names, but the faces look familiar, by Richard Avedon. I think that's his name, too. Hey, Bobby, it's a groove to have you on the show.
Right, man. Glad to be here.
Yeah, Bobby used to be a program director, didn't you? Choose those records up and stuff.
Right, I used to program for a Murray the K show.
Yeah.
Over at another radio station. And it was an interesting experience.
Oh, I bet it was.
Real interesting, right? I was very fortunate to be able to have the freedom to play whatever I wanted to play. And pick whatever music, you know.
Well, I know you had a lot to do with the exposure and development of groups such as The Doors.
Right, for example. And we were also fortunate to get exclusive on things like from England, you know, Jimi Hendrix Experience. And
oh, wow, he's one of my favorites.
What a turn on, really.
He's out of sight.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. You know, I produced The Animals, and both the old version and the new version. And Chaz Chandler quit the group about 18 months ago, along with four other guys, and left Eric to get four new animals. But this is all done on a very amicable basis because they all still belong to the same organization. And Chaz wanted to be a producer and wanted to stop traveling, and several of the other guys wanted to become writers. But anyhow, Chaz told me about this fantastic guitar player in the village that I should go down and cup.
Right.
And at the time, I was doing the album, and I couldn't get out of the studio, so he signed him and took him to England. That was Jimi Hendrix.
Right.
And, I wish I'd been there. But before we get into your story, which is like a heck of an interesting one, I want to play you a record that has a pretty strange and interesting title, too. This is Lalo Schifrin, who has that big Mission Impossible hit. And the name of the album from which this record is taken is The Dissection and Reconstruction of Music from the Past, as performed by the inmates of Lalo Schifrin's demented ensemble as a tribute to the memory of the Marquis de Sade. And this tune is called A Troubadour. Lalo Schifrin, his big band Troubadour, produced by Creed Taylor. Say, tell me, what is the life of a program director all about? Number one, how did you get the gig?
Well, it was purely by accident, first of all. It was first I met Murray the K at WINS, And when he was doing a different type of show then. But he had been robbed of his bongos. And he had said,
I didn't know Murray played bongos.
Murray plays a lot of things, yes. He's a very interesting man, yes. And I heard him on the air mention this, and I had a pair of bongos, so I came up to WINS, like 1 o'clock in the morning.
This was before they went to All News, they were a rock station.
Right, complete rock then. And I brought up bongos, and here, you know. And then I started playing bongos with him on the air. And he started playing with a little brush, a snare brush, like on the drums, and he used to bang on an old tape recorder or something. He'd just hammer on anything, on a desk, anything at all.
Secretary's head.
Right. And then I just got into programming a show, purely by accident, you know. But it was very interesting, it was a guess.
Sounds like my story. You were an intense fan of the music who somehow found himself all of a sudden thrust out there in the position. Right,
right. Right. I said, what am I doing here, my God, you know, right? But I was telling you, one of the most, like, interesting things that ever happened to me as a programmer was when listeners would call in and they would request songs. And one day this person called in and he had a slight accent and he was from India. And he requested a Ravi Shankar album. And it was like a big thrill because, you know, pop market, Ravi Shankar and the sitar. I said, wow, I couldn't believe this was happening. I said, my God, what's happening to the world? You know, we're getting somewhere now. It's universal music. That's
right,
beautiful.
It is. Everything is everything. That's
right.
Our motto on this show.
Right.
I'm producing a guy called Harumi, and we've tried to go a little more eastern. You know, first it moved into the area of India, right? And now we're over in Japan with the samisen and the koto and the shakakuchi flute and all that sort of thing, you know. More about that later. Here's something that I owe to Billy Joe, and I'll pay Jerome Richardson, who is blowing here from his Groove Merchant album.
Mindless cretins, grope through idiosyncrasy fields, rising up, down.
That's okay.
Dig that. That's a groove. This is the ultimate. I know you normally don't like spinach.
Blech, I hate spinach.
But you're gonna love this.
Some spinach package.
You're delightful, you know that?
Shiver, shiver.
It's like a gentle invasion of the classics, huh?
The sound of the wind. It gives you a whole feeling.
Ultimate Spinach.
On MGM Records. Available at your local dealer.
See, you've been brainwashed. You've been spinach washed.
You're from around these parts?
Yeah, Long Island.
Yeah.
Long Island.
You always lived out there?
No. Only for 26 years of my life. Before that, I don't know where.
Oh, you were in another interesting culture. Though.
Yes, right.
Another, what do they call it in Buddhist terms?
Another world.
Yeah, karma and all that stuff.
Another world altogether.
Tell me this. What's this new thing you've got going on at MGM? You're an artist now as well as being a programmer.
Right. Artist, doing a little producing, a little writing. Very, very intricate.
In what vein? I mean, give me an idea.
Symphonic pictures. That type of an idea. Not staying in any bag too long. Expressing things lyrically. Having the music... give it support, whatever the lyric might say. And I'm into everything, every type of social commentary there is, referring to my life in forms of colors, which is a good plug for the album, My Rainbow of Colors.
That's the name of the album.
Yeah, that's cool, right.
With what you know, just from what you've unconsciously absorbed by picking and listening intently and professionally to groups, when this all comes out refined through what you are inside as a person, it should be out of sight.
Oh, it's a guess. Really, it's exciting because I write songs. I don't play an instrument. I just do it in my head. And it's when I hear it coming out, it's like beautiful just to hear the music.
Yeah. How many people do you use? Do you use an orchestra or do you use a small group format or what?
Whatever it may be. You know, sometimes it's just a guitar, and then it might be a complete classical orchestra.
Mm.
Complete. And from one state of mind to another.
When's it going to be finished?
Good question. Soon. Soon. Yes.
I know what you mean. They hound me all the time. Have you finished it yet? It's not finished until it's finished, is it, buddy?
Right. That's where it is.
Well, let me introduce you to one of my favorite people. I know you've heard her before, but on this particular song, she does it so well. It's from her Odetta LP on Verb Forecast. And it is Odetta Felius, and the tune is Love Songs of the Nile.
Linger a while.
big fat voice of Odetta, Love Songs of the Nile. And here's one of her favorite artists, James Cotton. She had quite a workout with James down to the Cafe El Gogo recently, and I think they're going to be making an LP together soon. I think it'd be a marvelous combination. This tune you hear a lot on the James Cotton list of things to do, because it's such a dynamic number. I've heard him do it in person. It always knocks me out. 2 minutes and 46 seconds of Good Time Charlie.
They call me Good Time Charlie, playboy with a whole lot of soul. They call me Good Time Charlie, playboy with a whole lot of soul. I'm the love of the big time spenders. I keep a pocket full of gold.
Evie Sands, Billy Sunshine, coming up next on The Music Factory.
Oh, place to get my kicks on.
That is the grooviest looking album cover I've ever seen.
Let's see.
Hey, I saw that crazy looking thing on a famous poster. It's a sop with camel.
It's not a camel, it's a dromedary.
What the heck is a dromedary?
Well, it's like a camel. Only camels have two humps, dromedaries have one.
Well, then why don't they call it the sop with dromedary?
Grander than the grandest hippodrome of ancient Rome, the great
What's a sop with?
Well, it's a World War I plane.
Well, then why don't they call it the World War I dromedary?
Because they call it the sop with camel.
Hello, hello. I like your smile.
It's a sop with camel on Camel Sutra.
No, Kama Sutra. Available at your local dealer.
Oh, wow.
Yo, well, you know, I'm hearing that subliminal lunch whistle here on the Music Factory, Bobby, and I usually take the guest out to lunch. So I've arranged a little thing for you. And because you're so regally attired today in your blue velvet trimmed in silver and with a beautiful silver medallion around your neck, Bobby Callender,
right.
I've got something special for you. You know how in these fancy restaurants you get these lamb chops with pants on them, little white frills around the end of them? Well, today for you,
yes.
I have pig's feet with desert boots on them.
Pig's feet with desert boots.
Yeah, it's going to be out of sight. I hope you worked up a big appetite.
I'm starving. My God, yes, I'm starving.
In case I don't survive this lunch, my name is Tom Wilson, and this is the Music Factory.
WABC 95.5 FM, New York.
In the 30s, unions were a dirty word, and the robber barons hired goon squads to keep them in line.
Daddy said no, Daddy said no.
Today's unions are a power, a force to be reckoned with.
My love is violet blossom.
The power and the force explode in the Beacon Street Union, from Boston, where the new American Revolution has exploded. Join the Beacon Street Union? You figure it out.
Well, meanwhile, back at the ranch, Claude Hall of Billboard magazine has dug up a few artifacts from out behind the cistern there. Will you knock it on us?
Well, Tom, I thought I'd tell you this week about something that's happening in radio. It's pretty exciting. It's called underground radio. I've put my own term on it. We call it progressive rock. And it's about groups like The Doors, probably The Bagatelle when their record comes out.
Yeah, groovy.
The Beacon Street Union. There are several stations that are now using this type of music almost extensively, meaning they're doing away with the Mickey Mouse rock and roll with any other type of music. One of them's in St. Louis, KSHE-FM. Another one's in Detroit, WABX-FM, which is almost all the way in this format. You've got WNEW-FM here in New York.
Oh, my friend Roscoe.
Right. And KFMK-FM in Houston is now a progressive rock midnight to 6 a.m.
You mean we got one in Texas? I never
Right.
Crazy.
They're progressive even down there. And WBZ up in Boston has a Sunday show. Dick Summer up there is really coming through strong with this type
of music. Oh, he's fantastic. I've heard a lot of fantastic things about that show.
Right. Yeah. It's reaching out several states. And in San Francisco, a station called KSFR-FM is slowly going into this type of format. They're making a change gradually. But this is going to be great for progressive rock groups.
Yeah, it sure is. You know, doesn't Tom Donahue in L.A. have one of those?
Right. I forgot all
about
Tom. He's an old buddy of mine, too.
Right.
Tom has KPPC-FM in L.A. and KMPX-FM in San Francisco.
Oh, I didn't know he had two stations going.
Right. And he's program director of both, and he's a disc jockey on both. Whichever town he's in, he tapes a show for the other town.
Oh,
he goes back
beautiful.
And forth at will. So he's a man of two cities.
We need a shuttle like that. Hey, that's great, Claude. Thank you for bringing that information about underground radio, and I'm going home and get my crystal set all polished up.
I'm going back to my cave.
Hey, Groovy. See you next week. There he goes into the distance, riding the great horse billboard, Claude Hall.
Yeah, Bobby Callender, our guest here on the Music Factory.
Tis I.
That lunch didn't come up to my expectations. I sent a threatening note to the chef that those pig's feet tasted like they'd been cooked in old tennis shoes rather than desert boots, and I specifically asked for brown desert boots, and my boots were overdone anyhow.
I noticed that.
You'll get much better when you come back here the next time.
I thought it was strange that you were walking around barefooted. Very strange. What kind of a thing is this? Okay. That's fine, though.
Well, that's what you get.
Right.
Oh, well, Claude Hall, my man. Dave Van Ronk's my man, too. He's on the show recently. Do you ever listen to his stuff?
Yes. Very interesting.
Yeah. This new Hudson Dusters sound that he has is great because he's gone electric. And this Clouds has some of the greatest words I've ever heard in rock and roll music, if you want to call it rock and roll. Clouds is our next selection.
Rose and flows of angel's hair and ice cream castles in the air and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way. Now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done. But clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds. Illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way. Now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go. If you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I
dreams and schemes and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Tears and fears and circus crowds. I look at life that way. Now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained. In every day I've looked at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all.
One of the most perfect readings of a very beautiful song, Dave Van Rock, his new electric sound. He calls himself now Dave Van Rock and the Hudson Dusters, and the name of that tune was Clouds, and it's just masterful. Bobby, we're going to investigate now what you've been telling us by playing a demonstration disc. It's not a finished record, I know. It's not mixed down yet of...
Right, there may be some sounds on it.
Sad Massac from the Marquis de Sade, right? And from Baron Saka Massac.
Yes.
And this is my nightmare pick, and I really mean it this time, folks. This is a nightmare pick. No, but Bobby, we have an institution on here of having a record that I wish that I had produced, that I had bad dreams about because somebody else beat me to the idea. And this is the first time in a long time that I've been face to face with the man who outproduced me. And there are very few of those men left alive, I assure you.
Oh, thank you very much.
I'll give you a 3-minute head start when we leave the studio. But here it is, our nightmare pick, Bobby Callender and Saad Massac.
Saad Massac was a handsome young man who taught history at the local life. Though he never enjoyed the stuff himself, to be sociable he'd always try. No one but mostly everyone agreed he was very good looking and always acting polite. His classes were very popular amongst all the kids in school. As he admitted that he was queer, he really thought he was cool. His fellow teachers looked on him as being somewhat of a nut and constantly talked behind his back, but he just ignored the pretty things they said. After a year of teaching at the high, he decided to resign from his position and left under that condition. He then went on a voyage around the world in search of nurses said, it's a pity he's not somewhere else enjoying life. Instead of here with us and somewhere out of his head.
As I was a-walking one morning in May, I spied a young couple a-making of hay. Oh, one was a fair maid, and her beauty shone clear. And the other was a soldier, a bold grenadier.
Bathsheba sings in the haunting English countryside, in the wind-swept hills and valleys of Thomas Hardy's classic Far From the Madding Crowd. Now a Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer movie starring Julie Christie. A violently beautiful love story. The original soundtrack recording of Far From the Madding Crowd, now on MGM Records at your local record dealer.
Man, that's Saad Masak, young school teacher.
Yes.
Too much.
Don't get too deep with it. Let's leave it a mystery. We'll let them figure it out if they can figure it out.
That's really a happening thing. It's just beautiful.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Tom, I brought along a couple of tracks from the album. Just plain rhythm tracks without my voice on it. From one of the cuts, it's called Symphonic Pictures. And it's just rhythms. But nice things, I think. Maybe you might dig them.
Hey, love to play it. We like to get right in there and dig behind the scenes of what's happening. Spin it.
It's just one little picture within my symphonic pictures. The next one changes mood altogether, and it gets into the youth of today and expresses it in a different tempo. So try this one.
Hey, who's that playing bass on that?
Joe Mack.
And who was that playing guitar on the first
one? Hugh McCracken.
Those are two of my men, man. What are you doing using my phone?
Can't leave out Pretty Boy Purdy on drums.
Oh, that's with his sign?
Right. Little multicolored sign.
You have to visualize Purdy comes in. I have to tell the people what this is all about. He comes in and he has a little sign that he sets up on the music stand after he sets up his drums and everything. It says Pretty Boy Purdy at work, yes. The greatest or something like that. Anyhow, he advertises the fact that he's there in the room, right?
Well, he is.
And he is there.
He is, yeah. The next cut is another reflection, and it refers to what I believe might help everybody if we just got together and just dug each other. Like, let's love and not judge one another. And it goes something like this. Thank you.
Oh, that's going to be a beautiful album, man. Mm-hmm. Those tracks are all part of the same piece, right?
One song, right. I have four more sections to do. African drums and sitars and just mind things, just so you can listen and enjoy listening.
You're blowing my mind, I'll tell you that. I'm going to get this album. What's going to be the title of the album?
I think my Rainbow of Colors.
Yeah.
That's close.
That's going to be too much. We're talking here with Bobby Callender, who has bridged the gap between being a person who programs records to being a producer and artist on a record. He's doing his thing and producing it. It's fantastic. And my hat off to Lenny Shear for having the guts to go out there for MGM and cop you, man.
He was beautiful.
A lot of people blew, I understand.
I went to so many different labels, and they themselves, the heads of the labels, they liked the songs, but they were afraid that it might be too progressive, which I disagreed with, naturally. And they said, hey, if you were the Beach Boys or the Beatles or something like that, well, maybe then you'd be accepted, but they won't accept you as just an unknown artist. Which shows the problems that you run up against in this business.
Oh,
and it was nice to run into Lenny Shear.
I think it's the fact that most people underestimate the people who buy records today, and I'm beginning to have an opinion, as prejudicial though it may be, that most of the people who have that mythological, fabled average age of 12 are over 45.
Mm-hmm.
I think people under 45 have a much higher tolerance of all sorts of new sounds and things.
I'll agree.
Here's the ultimate spinach.
I'm hungry again. Yes.
Get out another desert boot. Sacrifice of the moon.
Thank you.
So beautiful. Sacrifice of the Moon and four movements from the new album by the Ultimate Spinach. And it's marvelous, man. The Free Design, Umbrellas.
Street in the rain, my umbrella high up in my head, wet sidewalks and gutters and rain, lightly falling from the sky, lightly falling, lightly falling, lightly falling from the sky. Umbrellas are in bloom, flourishing, nourished by the rain. I walk down the street in the rain, my umbrella high up on my head, by up, 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 by title again?
My Rainbow of Colors.
Well, I'm going to get it myself.
Right. I'd just like to mention real quick that Alan Lorber is also producing this album with me, and he's a fantastic man to work with.
Oh, he's a beautiful cat, man.
Paul Harris is helping me arrange it, and a young lady by the name of Chris is helping me inspire.
Oh, wow.
It's inspiration.
I know those other two cats. Let me meet Chris.
No, man, no.
This show was brought to you by MGM and Verve Records out of desperation. My name is Tom Wilson, and my producer is a turncoat named H.H. Collin. Because